Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Benjamin Sandersen, and I'm very happy to share some thoughts and ideas about the work in our group today on the 75th anniversary of CWI. I work in the scientific computing group at CWI, and in our group, we work on developing new algorithms that, simply said, help to predict the future. Today, I want to explain to you how the concept of structure can be used to combine physical models and data-driven techniques to make such predictions robust. For example, our group works on the development of algorithms that will help us to predict the future of our weather and climate. A particularly important question that needs to be addressed is how to represent clouds in climate models. This is a difficult problem, because the simulation of clouds on the computer based on physical models is computationally very expensive. And at the same time, the amount of measurement data is very limited. So we cannot rely on purely data-driven techniques. A second example in which we wish to make accurate predictions of the future, given the state of today, is in the prediction of fluid flows in energy systems, such as sloshing of liquefied natural gas, which you see on the left, or wind turbine wakes in large offshore wind farms on the right. In wind farms, we want to predict what the effect is of the weather on the electricity production, for example, and how the turbines in the farm can be controlled in order to maximize the power or to address the needs of the electricity grid. Recently, we also started to look at predicting the future of the coronavirus spread and the uncertainty associated with the model predictions, together with colleagues from Erasmus University. For example, on the right, you see an evaluation of four different strategies, such as lockdowns or contact tracing, and what their expected effect is on the number of people on the intensive care. These examples from climate, energy, and COVID have one feature in common. At the basis, they have fundamental physical models or laws, such as conservation of mass or conservation of energy, which are often expressed in terms of differential equations. I call this the classic approach to predict the future, which is dominantly physics-based. The core strength is the universality and generality of the approach. However, at the same time, making future projections with these models can still be very difficult. On the right, you see an example of a physics-based simulation of a simple double pendulum system. As you will see, a very small change in conditions, in this case, the gravitational constant, can lead to completely different results in the long run. The nonlinear chaotic nature of these models and the uncertainty present in their formulation makes future predictions with only physical models difficult. Another complication is that for realistic applications such as climate predictions, these models are computationally very expensive to solve. As a result, data-driven techniques have become very popular. The premise is that if sufficient data of a system is available, artificial intelligence or machine learning can be used to learn the system behavior and make predictions about the future. While this has indeed been shown for classification tasks in image recognition or when playing games like Go or chess, this seems to be very difficult for physical systems such as the climate or a wind turbine wake. A main issue is that machine learning methods typically require big data, while in many physical systems, we typically only have very little data, for example, observations of the climate. Furthermore, it is difficult to guarantee that machine learning methods satisfy physical constraints, to have them generalize outside the conditions for which they were trained, and to make them robust to changes in the inputs. In this movie, which you see on the right, we have trained a neural network to predict the solution of a very simple physical system, a mass spring system. The neural network is trained on a number of noisy observations, which you see in gray dots, of the correct physical solution, which is a perfect circular orbit, as shown in black. The neural network solution in red is, however, not aware of the physics behind this problem and leads to a divergent prediction of future states. So the way to tackle these issues and the way forward to make robust predictions of the future is to tightly integrate physical models and data-driven techniques. I believe that such an integration is to be accomplished by embedding what I call structure in both components. This will not only help to make predictions by learning physics based on data in the blue arrow, but also to improve predictions by enhancing physics models by embedding data in the red arrow. So you might wonder, what does this mean, structure? So many physical models possess a certain kind of structure. For example, when formulating the equations of motion for the double pendulum that we just saw, it turns out there is a sort of hidden conserved quantity known as the Hamiltonian, which expresses that energy is conserved by the system. Well, in fact, more in general, there is a deep connection between conservation laws and symmetries in physical systems that was formalized by Emmy Noether. Maybe you know her when you make reservations for one of the rooms at CWI. When simulating physical systems on a computer, it is of critical importance to detect which conservation laws, symmetries, or invariants are important for the system under consideration and to preserve them when discretizing from a continuous to a discrete setting. So what do I mean by that? Well, here is an example again of the double pendulum problem. An important structure, as I said, in this system is conservation of the Hamiltonian. When simulating this system on a computer, it's not self-evident that the Hamiltonian will still be conserved. On the right, you see two simulations, one with a method that does conserve the Hamiltonian and one with a method that does not conserve it. Although at first sight, both simulations look reasonable, the method that does not conserve structure leads in the long term to completely wrong results, as the pendulum ends up at a higher position than where it started. So, structure-preserving methods are of crucial importance to obtain physically realistic results. The main ongoing question is now whether we can use structure-preserving techniques to design new data-driven methods. The idea is that if we can do this, we expect data-driven methods to have some of the universality that physical models have, meaning that they need less data, they generalize better to unseen cases, they satisfy physical constraints, and they could be more robust to perturbations. The main idea is therefore to design neural networks analogous to physical models. Of course, the question is again how to do that. The core idea is as follows. Recently, it has been shown that there is a deep link between neural networks and differential equations. This link allows us to interpret neural networks as a special case of a discretized differential equation. At the same time, we know already for a long time that there is a link between physical models and differential equations, as most physical models that we consider can be expressed in terms of differential equations. So the interpretation of neural networks as differential equations allows us to make a link to physical models. Since we know how to embed structure in physical models, this gives us an idea on how to include structure also in data-driven techniques. And finally, to make more robust predictions about the future. So let's go back to the data-driven example that I showed before, where we had noisy observations of a mass spring system and the neural network prediction that diverged from the circular orbit. We now change the neural network architecture so that we learn the Hamiltonian of the system. This enforces that the Hamiltonian is conserved and leads to accurate and stable predictions, as you can see here in blue. Our first results indicate that these networks are less sensitive to perturbations, they need less training data, and they lead to physically realistic solutions. So, to summarize, in our scientific computing group, we are developing advanced computational models that help to address grand challenges in topics like climate change and energy transition. Preserving structure when setting up computer simulations and designing data-driven techniques is a cutting-edge research topic, which will be a guide when making predictions about the future. I'd like to finish now with congratulating CWI with its 75th anniversary. And please let me know if you have any questions. Thank you very much.